Welcome to Hide and Seek TV. It's your boy Hide and Seek, and I'm back again with another video live from Seattle, Washington. And I'm about to delve deep into this because this right here is going to be pertaining to the solar eclipse. It's about to go down April 8th. Like, I already been covering it in some videos, but I'm really going to focus on it on this video, and I'm going to explain the symbology and what's really about to, you know, about to really fulfill. So first off, I'm going to start it out with Isaiah 19:19. In that day there shall be an altar to the Lord in the midst of the land of Egypt, and a pillar at the border thereof to the Lord, and it shall be for a sign and for a witness unto the Lord of hosts. Colossians 2:17, which are a shadow of things to come, but the bodies of Christ. So as you can see, the top of the altar is measured at 76 degrees, and it foreshadows the kingdom to come. You see what I'm saying? So let's delve into that about this shadow. So like I've been telling y'all about the Exodus and everything that's about to fulfill, and it's very important to be prepared, you know, with everything that's going on with the signs. And, you know, we're preparing ourselves with prayer, with seeking the Lord, with, you know, repentance, and preparing our hearts for that day that's coming, that's approaching. So in 1 Thessalonians 4:17, you know, as it's written, then which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we forever be with the Lord. So the clouds is very important, because when you understand the clouds, you know, it all goes into the whole theme of what's spiritual is physical. So, you know, wherefore seeing we are also encompassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses. You see what I'm saying? So the Exodus being joined with the Lord in the air by plane, you know, the planes is coming. If you pay attention to all of the news and everything, you see a lot of plane symbolism, which I'm about to get into in a minute. But we're going to talk about this eclipse. So as you can see, you know, the eclipse going for it's going to be an X that's going to form across the U.S. map. The whole total eclipse, you know, if you pay attention, every election year, this usually go down. But, you know, this year is the year of the dragon, and this is a very serious year. Like I said about the Antichrist, Barack Obama, he's going to be 63 this year. You know, that's 666. So I'm going to delve into that, you know, six threes. So as you can see, it's forming a shadow across, like, Cali, Mexico, which I'm going to get into in a minute. You know, northern Texas. You know, it's going across the whole way across Ohio. And I was just out in Cleveland, too. And people is already booking their Airbnbs, their hotel rooms to, you know, watch the eclipse is about to go down. And I'm going to get into that in a minute. But as you can see, you see how it's all forming across, because the X is the symbol of Christ. And it's going to, you know, go across Memphis, because Memphis, as we know, I just read it about the altars being in Egypt. So you see, that's why Memphis, you know, in the spiritual Egypt that we in, got to have a huge effect with the eclipse as well. Because this whole theme is just all going into how the Son of Righteousness is being revealed, you know. And like, as you can see, Kansas is right in the mix. Remember, I already talked about that with the Wizard of Oz. Remember how you had Dorothy. Remember how she was went through Kansas to get to Emerald City, because, you know, Emerald City, you know, that all just goes into the whole theme of the Kingdom of Heaven. You know, so this stuff is serious. And remember that going to, I'm going to get into Texas, because like I've been showing y'all for the longest about the birthplace of the Messiah with Port Arthur. You know, I'm going to get into that in a minute. That's why you see Beyonce is talking about, yo, this ain't Texas. You know, Texas hold them. You know, they can't hold them no more. You know, they can't hide them no more. It's people are waking up. You know, they saying the storm is coming, because they know the storm goes into, remember on Wizard of Oz, remember she got to Emerald City through the tornado, the whirlwind, because in Ezekiel 1:4, it's written the Messiah is revealed via the whirlwind, you know what I'm saying? So it's all that, you know, the storm, Lil Durk, you know, the storm, you know, in the song Old Days, he talking about thunderstorms and blackouts. You know, J. Cole mentioned the storms on the song with Benny the Butcher. Johnny P's caddy, you know, he said on the night he was born, you know, the storm and the rain and the storm and lightning was striking, you know. But I was just saying the whole theme of letting you know they possessed with the fallen spirits, you know, the fallen angels, you know, through their Freemasonry, you know, they just, you know, as it's written, Lucifer fell as lightning. So, I mean, they all just let you know they was a part of that legion of that, but I'm going to keep it rolling. But you see, Kansas is in the mist, because as I explained, You know, he was going to be within Kansas. That's why Kansas area code is 316. And John 3:16 sent his only begotten son. You know what I'm saying? And as you can see too, Kansas, in Psalm 78:26, he caused an east wind to blow into heaven, and by his power he brought in the south wind. So you see how the Messiah come through the south, you know, like Texas, and then you see Kansas, you know, going, you know, towards the Midwest, going towards the east. So the whole theme of the gathering, you know. That's why I had showed it in plenty of videos with the weather map. When you look at the winds, how the winds blow out of, around Kansas, through Kansas. You know, it's in Tornado Alley, you know. So none of this stuff is by mistake, man. Let's delve even further into this. All right, hear this right quick. Sirius. I'm going to Wichita. Far from this opera forevermore. He said, I'm going to Wichita. The Wichita, Kansas City. I'm going to work the strong. You know, Wichita, the city within the state of Kansas. But yeah, he said, I'm going to Wichita because they notice where the Messiah is at. Listen to this. And I'm bleeding, and I'm bleeding, and I'm bleeding right before the Lord. You see, I'm bleeding right before the Lord. You know what I'm saying? So it's all in our face, you know. I'm bleeding right before the Lord. I'm going to Wichita because when you understand Texas, Texas had a 776 zip code and it connects to the 316 Kansas. So, you know, through the 76, and then it's right in the Gulf. You know what I mean? The Gulf of Mexico. So that's very important to understand because, you know, in Luke 16:26, you know, as it's written, let me read it quick. It comes together, man, in Luke 16:26, you know, as it's written, and beside all of this, beside all this, between us and you, there is a great Gulf fixed. So you see, a Gulf, you know? So look at this right here. This is just, you know, this episode already, you know, happened, but this right here, the whole theme coming with episode 4, or it already happened or coming, but you see how it says the return of the prodigal son. And you notice how they getting on the planes. Look at this. The BMF show.
Look, fellas, we're in an unprecedented time right now.
Meech is back in town.
Yo, the king is in town.
He must be trying to...
You see the planes and return of the prodigal son.
Expand outside of Michigan.
Making it a great opportunity to strike.
We got nothing to lose and everything to gain.
See, they're dealing with the planes. You know what I'm saying? The prodigal son. You see that? And when you understand, too, about the whole theme of this, too, with the, you know, when it's with the solar eclipse, you know, it's written, that they may know from the rising of the sun and from the west, there is none beside me. I am the Lord, and there is none else. So you understand the whole thing. As the sun, you know, it's going to rise, you know, and the whole thing, when you understand we're dealing with the sun, because as it's written, you know, the Messiah, you know, rises from the, you know, shining from the east to the west. You know, it's lightning shine from the east to the west. So the east goes to the eastern hemisphere when he was, you know, Yahushua the first time. You know, walking amongst Jerusalem, and this time now, you know, rose up, you know, rising up out of America with his people this time now. You know what I'm saying? So that goes into the west. So that's why the whole theme of the sun, you know, is very important. You know what I mean? Rising in the west, setting in the east, you know. And then vice versa, dealing with the solar eclipse. So everything is coming together. It's letting you know that the whole theme now, the Messiah is about to be revealed. You know, it's all elevating, you know. So you see, that's why you see Ohio is one of the main places that people are going to be able to see it. Because like I said, I was out in Cleveland like last week. And that's what they were, they had it all over the billboards. Yeah, come to, you know, people are booking their Airbnbs, booking hotels. They're ready for the solar eclipse. You know, wear your sunshades, you know. They want to have, you know, it's all symbology. I'm not saying don't wear it, but I'm just talking about, like, the symbology behind it. You know, put on your shades because they don't want the sun, the light of God, you know, to shine upon them. That's why they had that, you know, I'll wear my sunglasses at night, you know. But you see how they said Ohio is the birthplace of aviation. So that's dealing with the planes again. You see what I'm saying? You see the whole theme, how it's casting a shadow, the solar eclipse casting a shadow, because as it's written, which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of Christ, you know. So it all come together. You see, let's look at some of the places. You see, it obviously it's going to take place on April 8th. That's 4-8. You know, I'm going to get into that in a minute, about the 48. But you see how the main cities, you got, you know, obviously Mexico, which I'm going to talk about in a second. You know, like I was just talking about with Texas. You know, Little Rock, Arkansas, hint the Ark. You know, like the Ark of the Covenant, dealing with the law of God. The Little Rock, Christ is the Rock. Then you got the Ohio, and then you got Buffalo, New York. You see what I'm saying? I'm getting to that. But you see how the next one is in 2044. So you understand that 44, like I always explain, it goes into the whole theme of the dealing with the law of God, the Ark of the Covenant. That's why Obama had to be the 44th president, because, you know, that was showing the Antichrist came into power, you know. So you see that whole theme with the 44. You see the 2044. And you see everybody is buying Airbnbs, because it's, but they want everybody outside their house watching it, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, like they're in the first Exodus, everyone went inside their houses. They remarked the lamb's blood upon their doorposts and stayed in so that they can be prepared for the Exodus. You see? That's no coincidence. So let's go into Revelation 12. We're going to talk about that 48. So, and there appeared on April 8th, 4-8, you know, and there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars, and she being with child, travailing in birth, and pain to be delivered. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads, 10 horns, 7 crowns upon his head. And the dragon stood before the woman, which was ready to be delivered, for to devour her child as soon as it was born. And she brought forth a man child, who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron, and her child was caught up into God, into his throne. So you see the red dragon. You know, the 7 heads, 10 horns, 7 crowns. You know, 7 times 10 is the 70s. You know, the 7 crowns. You know, he has to have a birth date. So, you know, obviously the 7 heads, 10 horns, 7 crowns. And as we saw, that the top of the altar is measured at 76 degrees. And, you know, the pyramids stand 5,776 inches. And, you know, the sun burns 5,776 degrees on its surface. So, you know, the 5 for, like, the 5th day. You know, the first 7 is for the 7th month. And then the 76, 5, 7, 7, 6, the 7-6 for the 76th year that he returned. So, you know, that'll be July 5th, 1976. You see? And there's no way around none of this once you know it. Like, I showed it millions of times in the videos, you know? So, you see the whole thing. That's why 1976 was the Chinese Dragon Year. You know, in the 1970s, you see, I said they was trying to devour him before he was born. 1970s, abortion was legalized, feminism was increased, and so forth. Condom commercials advertised. You see, they had songs said that I'm back in 1976. You see, you heard, you miss me, well, I'm back. You know, you see that? That's why, as it's written, you know, the cloud of witnesses. That's why Apple. And Apple and Microsoft was formed 1976. You see that? But, you know, you had that song, that show, Welcome Back, Cotter. Remember, they're like, welcome back to that same old place that you laughed about me about, which is playing the videos. Came out 1975, going to 1976, because they knew that was the time he was going to be conceived, in the fall of 75. And that show came out in the fall of 1975. He's born July 5th, 1976. So they knew that that was 9 months of conception. And that's just how they work, you know. Because they know the prophecy, but they keep it hidden from you, you know. In Matthew 24:32, now learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and put forth leaves, know that the summer is near. So basically all it's saying, you know, that he was returning in the summer. So it's about knowing how the Messiah is going to return. That's why you see they was, you see Drake was on the railroad on sicko mode. You know, Drake just means dragon. And you see they got the moon blocking out the sun, because the moon goes to the Masons, the moon energy, trying to block out the sun of righteousness. You know? Don't want no Exodus. You see, as it's written, that That's why the eclipse about to happen too, because it's written immediately after the tribulation of those days, shall the sun be darkened. And the sun is going into, it's going into that Obamacare, you know. The whole thing dealing with Barack Obama, you know, the great Antichrist, you know, his influence over the world and deceiving the people is about to be over. I mean, you're still going to have people who reprobated minds, and I mean, you're still going to have people who are going to lack faith in things. But unto my real saints who are waking up, he's no longer going to have that threshold over our minds no more. People not, as you can see, every time a saint overcomes something, you know, people might think that they don't have an influence or impact on the world, that they mean nothing, but you do. You know, every time we overcome habits, sins, you know, we breaking chains around the world, you know. Look at sports. Look how many people, you don't really hear people, you know, the average person you talk to about sports today, they be like, you know, I even have people, I say, do you know who Anthony Edwards is? Who? Man, I don't know who that is, man. You know, people are on that because people are not as influenced by this stuff no more. If this was 2012, oh, yeah, man, I saw the highlights. Oh, no, I watched the whole 48 minutes and overtime, man. Man, I couldn't get off my seat. I had to use the bathroom. I was holding it. Man, I had to see what's going on. It's going down to the wire. You know, music don't have a strong influence on the people like it used to. People are waking up, man. You know, the fashion. You know, people waking up out of all of that because saints are breaking chains around the world, overcoming the devil. You know, it's a chain reaction. You know, we're a whole body of Christ, you know. So as you can see, that Obama sunlight, because as it's written in 2 Corinthians 4:4, and Obama is the 44th president, 2 Corinthians 4:4, you know, it says that Lucifer, the god of this world, blinded the minds of many. How do he do that? By being a false light, blinding your eyes. You see? So his light going to be darkened. Those books, they're going to be burned. That day coming when those books are going to be burned, you know? You notice that's why they're shutting down the libraries, and Obama was upset about that because he want people deceived with his books, you know, his knowledge filling you up with nothing. Don't know nothing about the word of God, but you know everything that, you know, Dr. Seuss got to say. You know what I'm saying? You know everything Dr. Seuss got, everything got to say. You know everything about the 48 laws of power and so forth, but don't know what the word and the prophecy say. You ask somebody what this is, you know, well, I believe that, you know, that's just this book, this man written that Bible, man, I don't read that. But they can read everything, you know, doctors, they know every word, cat in the hat, you know. With cat in the hat, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, you know. Get your hat on, go away, rain, go away. They know all of that, you know, when you say how the Messiah return, oh, you know, he don't exist, or, you know, he's coming from the sky, man. You know, he's going to just float down in his full glory and just rapture us all up. You know? Nah, it's not. I'm sorry about that. But for real, man, this is how this stuff got to come to an end, man. You feel me? So let's get a little deeper into this. So one of the main places, too, that's going to have it is San Diego as well. And I noticed too, a lot of these cities is like called the birthplaces of like either the state or like of some kind of like invention. You know, Buffalo, New York with the buffalo wings, because that go into the wings, the Exodus. You know, we're going to mount it with our wings. You know what I mean? Mount up on the plains. You know, but they want to eat the wings, you know. That's why Rick Ross, for his Wingstop commercial, he said, yeah, you know, we got a wing shortage, so now we're going to eat thighs. Because when you understand about the, you know, about the thigh, you know, that goes into how it says the Messiah will have King of Kings, Lord of Lords written on his thigh, you know. So that's very important to understand when it's talking about the wings. That's why Buffalo, New York, one of the main places, you know. And you see, you got Carmen San Diego. So you see, that's why San Diego, one of the main things, because you see Carmen San Diego. They was like, where on earth is Carmen San Diego? And she run around the pyramids, you know, kind of like disguised, you know, seek me. Those who seek me shall find me, you know. Her name Carmen, because the word car derives out of Kara, Karas, which is the ancient Hebrew way of saying, you know, Christ. Christ is just the Greek way of saying Karas, Kara. Which just means the anointed one. So you got Carmen San Diego. Where on earth is Carmen San Diego? You know? And you see, they said the day that it's going to, let me go back to it. I think I skipped past it. But yeah, it's very important, man, to pay attention to all of this, you know, for real. Let me pull it up, because it's like, this is important. Like, it's no way around none of it. So they said San Diego, let's look it up. They said that it's going to be visible at 11:11 a.m. It's the best time to see it, you know. You see that? 11:11, because that 11:11, when you understand the whole thing too, the 11 deals with the doors. You know, the 11 deals with the path. You know what I'm saying? So you got 11:11. You know, in Genesis 11, you had Nimrod, you know, the first king of Babylon, you know, who created Babylon, who created the whole aspect of paganism that we're dealing with today, you know. So you see how you got Alaska Airlines, people going to be going to San Diego and everything, because they already know that it's going to be that 11:11 connection. And, you know, they got the 48 because it's on April 8th, because 4-8 is just how they know the Messiah is going to be 48 years old this year, you know. And then 11:11 going to the two paths. So in Genesis 11, you got the one path where you following, building Satan's kingdom, you know, following the ways of Nimrod, you know, building the tower against heaven, you know, rebelling against heaven. And then you got the other side on the righteous aspect, you know, dealing with the doors. Because when you look at the number 11, it's like two doors. It's like a door, you know. So when you understand 11:11 for the right side, that'll all go into the whole aspect of Isaiah 11, which deals with the gathering of the saints. You feel what I'm saying? The whole theme of the great gathering of the saints of God. You know, that the Lord shall set his hand again the second time to recover the remnant of his people. And he shall set up an ensign for the nations and shall assemble the outcasts of Israel and gather together the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth. You see? And then, and the envy also of Ephraim shall be departed, and the adversaries of Judah shall be cut off. Ephraim shall not envy Judah, and Judah shall not vex Ephraim. So that's why it's dealing with the Mexico connection. That's why it's casting that shadow across Mexico, because it's all just going into the whole aspect, you know, of the tribes that's dispersed around the four corners. You know, the northern tribes of Israel, and then you got the southern kingdom of Judah coming together, the two sticks being brought together. Because everything is being bisected. You know, the X is forming. Christ is gathering up the saints around the four corners. That's what this all is symbolizing. You know, like on a basic level of understanding it, you know. So that's why you see Buffalo Wild Wings with Buffalo, New York. It deals with the wings, the Exodus. You see? Then you got Island. Like, I think I talked about this a long time ago. But this is a show called The Island. Like, as it's written, let us be sober and watch and not be drunken as the others. So on Netflix, it's a show called The Island. It's serious, you know. They not, I don't want to really spill it because, you know, it'd be something that, you know, the suspense of it. But basically on the show, they, you know, they end up in the island and they're in Texas. And they're out in Texas, and basically, like, they're going through an aspect of redeeming themselves. Being redeemed by making the right choices, basically getting a second chance at life. So it was all just showing, this came out around, like, 2020-ish, when the whole Rona situation happened, which all, notice that again, the solar eclipses, and then, you know, Corona is the surface of the sun. So it all deals with the sun of righteousness. That's why you remember Corona claimed everything. Notice the clubs is not like they used to be popping, you know, the sports and so forth. You know, remember that affected a lot of the gathering, because people had to be, you know, remember how it says he was coming to divide good from evil, and he was coming to bring a sword, you know, a sword of truth to scatter up, you know, break up the families, meaning like the righteous are going to gather up with the righteous and the wicked with the wicked, you know. Bringing a division so he can bring forth the true peace. So notice how all that all happened when it's dealing with the sun, some kind of sun symbolism, you know. So let's look at this. This stuff is all coming together, man. It's all about who got the eyes to see and ears to hear. See, they already know the whole theme of the writing on the wall is about being revealed. You see how they're saying it won't happen. You see that it won't happen. They don't want the Exodus to fulfill. So you see, he's walking up the stairs because they want to be the ones who keep exalting themselves upon the altar. Here it is.
a new whip now. I started him off with a zip. He get a few bricks now.
You see how they dealing with the bricks inside the wall? Because in Revelation 3:12, as it's written, you know, those who overcome shall be a brick in my wall. You know, they should be a pillar, a stone in my altar. You see? High level.
I got a Starbucks boom and I make a ship touchdown. South 12, I really got...
You see that?
Got it off the curb and don't get the respect that I deserve.
You see that whole thing going into the Christ line. But notice how he's going like inside his prison. And then notice all of them, a lot of these songs, they all doing the same thing. They all reminiscing. Hear this.
I'm gonna take over the world. It was just me and my girl. First mixtape flop, that was that nerve. Trying to lock it down for self-respect. I might be on the verge. Told girls to come.
You see how he looking back at his old life, talking about how they reminiscing. You know? All of them talking about they reminiscing. They all talking about how they miss the old days and so forth. You know, look at this right here, man. All right, here it is. Same thing.
I'm in the zone, reflecting on my life and where I've been.
Say, he said he reflecting on his life and where he been.
I sip a Patron.
You see how, you know, see how they saying the whole thing. They talking about how they reminiscing on their lives, you know, because they know their time coming to an end. So let's listen to this right quick. Let's take it even further. There's no way around none of this, you know. It's all about who got the eyes to see and ears to hear. You know, this stuff is serious, man. Let's delve deep into this. Hold on. Let me get it right. There's no way around it, man. Like, for real. And once you catch on to what they really talking about, you know, it's more, you're more edified and you'll know, you know what I mean, like, the direction to take and to keep walking the narrow path, you know. All right, listen to this. Can you know how we must exalt the Messiah and raise him up? So hear what he say.
Them niggas drove. You know if he pulling up, then he coming with his pose.
You see how he said the whole thing, the car reference. You see how they all of these car references. Then he said the whole theme of, you know, he pulling up. You know, hint the whole theme of the exalting. Then hear what he say.
Nigga play with us, then bro wiping a nigga nose. His reaction.
You see, excuse the language, but wiping his nose. Because when they like to do that wiping the nose, I'm going to get into that right quick because... You know, it's very important to understand that because all that goes into is the whole theme of how they like to, how can I put it? Like how they like to basically put the branch against their nose for their masonry and reject the Messiah. Because as it's written, you know, we got to climb that altar. And they don't want him to be able to breathe. You know, in John 19:34, when he was crucified, his lungs got damaged. You know what I'm saying? So... They don't want him being able to breathe, so they don't want him to be able to climb that altar and get to the top. You feel me? So they put the branch against the nose. Remember how in Zechariah 6:12 it talks about how the Messiah returned and how he's the branch is called the man that will build the temple of his father. So, you know, they don't want him being able to be that man to build the temple. They don't want him to rise and stand on top of the altar. You know, that's why you have Pinocchio. Remember they say his nose was so long. Remember how he always said he wanted to be a real boy? Because they know that the Messiah, you know, he returned as a man, you know? And remember, Pinocchio was dealing with the whale because when you go into Matthew 12:40, let's read it. For as Jonas was 3 days and 3 nights in the whale's belly, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. So it all deals with the man out the sea. You know, the man out the sea is basically talking about how, you know, the sea is dealing with the people, like democracy, policies, you know, et cetera. It deals with people. So, you know, he's the man amongst the people being revealed. You know, he's the living waters, you know. So you see, that's why they say they wanted, they like to do that. They remember Pinocchio had the long nose, so they call him a liar. You know, every time he lie, his nose get longer, you know. And that's why, you know, when you translate the word praise the Lord, this is the name they've been hiding. Because in Isaiah 52:5-6, you know, it talks about through the blasphemy, his name will be revealed. They blaspheme his name all day long. So in Isaiah 12:4, you know, when you translate praise the Lord, it becomes Louis Eternal. You know, hint, hallelujah. You know, holly means to praise Louis Eternal Yah. You know, that's why I want to show power. You got Lewis right here, Lulu on the left, You see, he's walking with the Pinocchio theme on his shirt, on his sweater. You see that? Because it let you know that Lewis is the man out the sea that's going to be revealed. You know? So that stuff is very important. That's why you see right now, you know, it's dealing with Nineveh. You see all the cities, Nineveh, you know, Rapture, Indiana, Nineveh, Ohio, all of them that's going to see the main places for the solar eclipse. And then you got the Ark in Williamston, Kentucky, because 3:14, you know, as it's written, God said unto Moses, I am that I am. So hint the will of I am, the will of God, William. So they know the Messiah's name is Carol for Karas, for Kara, Lewis for Lewis Eternal, and then Williams for the I am, the second. You know, that's why Barack Obama's name is Barack Hussein Obama the second, because this is the second battle before the final battle. You know, this is the time of the gathering. You know what I'm saying? The third battle is when a 1,000-year reign is over. You know, near over, more so. So you see how all this stuff coming together, man. It's all about who got the eyes to see and ears to hear. You see. So you see, you got the Ark dealing with William. No way around none of that. All in the Nineveh, because remember during the time of Jonas, remember he was coming out the whale's belly during the time in the Nineveh, you know, preaching repentance. You see what I'm saying? So all of this coming together, you know. Just paying attention to the signs. Yeah, this stuff is important, you know. I'm going to show y'all this too. Pay attention to this right here. Notice this is Utah. So Utah deals with the jazz. You know, Utah jazz, that deals with the trumpets of God. You know. Look at this. It's no way around none of this at all. All right, Patrick, he do the dunk. He actually gave the guy John a head contusion. So that's all symbolic of the headstone symbology. Cause you see, that's why they had to do it against the jazz, dealing with the revelations, the trumpets. Like I put it in all the sports videos when I break it down. You know, the Greeks, you know, they were heavy on the sports because they used it to uncircumcise Israel. You know what I'm saying? And get them out of the holy circumcision of the Lord, you know? So here it is.
Oh, my God.
See how the guy said, oh my God. And then there was another dunk where John Johnson, who played for Hawks, he dunked on Austin Reeves the same night. And they said heavens, you know. So it's all letting you know, like, it's all coming together. So, you know, Anthony Edwards said that his finger got dislocated, because that dislocated finger, you know, it's all letting you know that the writing's on the wall, you know. You know, as it's written, in the same hour came four fingers of a man's hand and wrote over against the candlestick upon the plaster of the wall of the king's palace, and the king saw the part of the hand that wrote. So the finger of God, remember Moses stretched out his hand to part the seas during the Exodus, the type of thing. And then you got, what's his name? John with the head contusion, because like I said, that goes to the headstone, you know. So all this stuff coming together. You know, they already know that time, you know, coming into fruition, man. You know, like I had put in the videos before, how we already a nation. You know, 2016, you know, Lewis was anointed king of Judah, you know. And that was during the time Obama was getting ready to leave office. And then came Donald Trump, hint the trumpet, the jazz theme again, you know. And you see, like, on the show with Marvel, you had Carly, hint Kara, dealing with the cloud. And you see how she's gathering up saints, you know. The saints are being woke up. That's why they're doing that. Oh, don't spread false information, blah, blah, blah. Because they know that's how the saints, the cloud is waking up. You know, it's no way around none of this, man. You remember all of that was dealing with 2016. Remember March 9th, 2016, you know. It was, remember you had the solar eclipse when Obama was leaving the office. The Antichrist was leaving office. And then, like I said, the Trump came in, Donald Trump, you know, the trumpet came into office. And as it's written in 1 Corinthians 15:52, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. You see? Notice around that time, people started kind of going into the time of waking up, you know. Even out here, the other day, I had saw a report, and it was talking about how a man was, you know, shot down by the police, by the train track. And then it was like he got shot up by the train, the railroad. And then they had the railroad by Planet Fitness, you know. Because they know that time of that burden of Egypt, you know, that burden is being raised up and lifted off. But they want to prevent the exodus, you know. You see what I mean? So that's why I remember on that movie, The Forever Purge, remember you was dealing with so-called Mexicans. You remember that whole thing, they had to get to Mexico so they can flee the purge. Remember? So all of that stuff coming together, you know, it's all showing how everything is being gathered up. The saints are being gathered up from the four corners of the earth, you know. That's why on the purge, you see they got the CL on the trash can. Because, you know, the pollutions, you know, and all that, the ways of the heathen and the ways of sin and everything is going to be removed from the saints. You see, you got CL. You see how she's flashing the light and revealing the initials of the Messiah, CL, Carol Lewis, you know. So all of this coming together, you know, it's all about just paying attention and just, you know, knowing the signs. That's why, like I was talking about earlier, you see how they talking about Houston had the plastic bubble wrap caused a fire on the plane. Notice it's a lot of United flight too. You see, they said 8 incidents in 2 weeks, United flights. So you see the United hint the whole theme of the Exodus, the saints being united in the cloud to gather up and meet the Lord in the air. Notice a lot of United flights. So you see, they said the plastic started the fire because the plastic, remember as it's written, when the Messiah was crucified, the veil split. So that's dealing with the plastic, the veil, the curtain, you know. I'm going to get to that in a minute. But even on a movie called How It Ends on Netflix, that's a movie you can research as well. You see they got the plane crashed, and you see how you got William driving. There go William right there. He's driving.
The shot down?
You see they showing the plane. You know, so all this stuff coming together. I'm going to go back to the plastic in a minute, but listen to this too. You know, all of this stuff is just like a big puzzle, man, when you know what's going on. You see how he's looking at himself in the glass, in the mirror, because cleaning up his scars on his face. Because you remember the Messiah was by his stripes we are healed. By his crucifixion we are healed. So you see, for now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face now I know in part, but then shall I also be made known. You see? Look how he's looking in the mirror, cleaning up his face.
Mercy for the spirit, still praying for me. Time's hard, so forgive me if I smell funny. Sleeping in cars, they be real with no hotel money.
You see that? Sleeping in cars, you know. Just Masons, you know what I mean? How they just want to have a body to corrupt, you know, real people, man. Those fallen angels just want to possess, you know, reptilian race just want to possess real Karites, possess real bodies, become Kara themselves, and possess real people and deceive real people with their analogies of, you know, of what they want good and evil to be. You know, they want to tell what righteousness to be, you know. How you should be, what peace should be, what love should be. You know what I'm saying? Do what you want to do for you and that's it. You know, live your life for you and that's it. You know. Training people's hearts to live like that, man. So, you know, when there was no hotel money living in cars, you know they don't get their portion in heaven, you know. You know, they living in cars, you know. But you see how they said the United flight was the fire was caused by plastic bubble wrap. Let's delve into this, man. Like I said, that plastic going to that veil, they want to keep the Messiah hidden. You know, the man, they don't want the man behind the curtain revealed. They want to keep that curtain up. So that's why they got the United flights having the plastic fire, because that showed that veil is being unraveled, that the Exodus is about to fulfill with the saints being united, you know. You know. know, we're the light of the world. That's the symbology of the fire.
I said, you already know, nigga, you don't gotta flow.
Excuse the language, but listen to this.
Before rap, you don't really got dough. Before rap, you don't really seen snow. In the kitchen, about to make some magic. Then blow it all in magic. Pull up in my partner in traffic. Gave it to.
See that? He said, I pull up on my partner in traffic. They want to keep us jammed up, you know, in traffic.
Partner in traffic. Gave it to him, it was all in plastic.
See that? The plastic. They want to keep us veiled up. They want to keep the Exodus hidden, you know.
All I know, I ain't trying to go to jail. Heard that shit, closest thing to hell.
They don't want to go into the bottomless. They don't want to go to that bottomless pit. Let's hear it one more time. One more time.
Pull up in my partner in traffic. Gave it to him, it was all in plastic. All I know, I ain't trying to go to jail. Heard that shit, closest thing to hell.
How much? Like, how many times, man? Do you gotta hear hell and heaven in a song? All of these songs. All of these songs, man. Listen to this right here.
Rip me out the plastic, I've been acting brand new.
You see? Rip me out the plastic, I've been acting brand new. You know, all that plastic, like, over and over. Them two different genres of rap, you know? That Alice in Wonderland, you remember how it says what Lewis Carroll found through the looking glass, you know, what Alice found there, because they know the Messiah's going to return as a man, and they're going to know his name and everything. You see how Alice represents the bride Israel, the kingdom of heaven, you know, seeing a man behind the curtain being revealed, the plastic. That's why the name Cara, you know, Caroline, derives from Cara, Carol, you know, it's the feminine way of saying Carol. Notice why you see she had to deal with Young Dolph's murder. Because of Young Dolph, you know, that Dolph just goes to the man out the sea, the dolphin. Remember Dolph? Remember Flipper? And I put this in the comment section below, too, and I broke down Young Dolph when it happened. But remember Flipper? How he used to, you know, kill the sharks? You know, the Dolph, the Messiah, is the man out the sea slaying the beast, the Antichrist, you know? It's just all symbology, but I'll put that in the comment section. You know, I'm not going to elaborate on that right now. But, you know, people be thinking, yeah, I got my L.A. cap, you know. And L.A. just goes to Louisiana, which is just Lewis, you know. But they make you think it's dealing with Los Angeles, but really it's the fallen angels who blaspheme the holy name Lewis Eternal. That's why Barack Obama said, I'm Daniel's Day-Lewis. Because he was letting you know the prophet Daniel said in the last days the Antichrist will blaspheme the holy name of the Lord, Lewis Eternal. You know? That's why they be running to my dear Lewis wearing a Louis Vuitton. I forgot to play that part too. Let me go back to this real quick. Listen to this, y'all. And it's going to make more sense. Listen to this. All in our face.
Have mercy for the spirit still praying for me. Time's hard, so forgive me if I smell funny. Sleeping in cars, they be real with no hotel money. Louis Vuitton, you just get it cause your man want it. Pictures in-
you see that? That stuff's serious, man. But you see how they do the Lewis, because he's talking about the cars, you see? The car of Lewis. So you see you got the LA really going to Louisiana, Lewis, you know? But they really try, it's just the lost angels, the fallen angels, blaspheming the holy name Lewis. That's why in Louisiana is very important, because Louisiana and Texas, because it's in the Gulf. You know, and as it's written, but if you turn unto me and keep my commandments and do them, though there will you cast out an uttermost part of the heaven, yet I will gather them from thence and will bring them unto the place I have chosen to set my name there. So that goes into the slave ship connection with Deuteronomy 28:68. Coming into the spiritual Egypt by boat through Louisiana, you know. That's why they're trying to erase that whole narrative, and they're trying to push people into, yeah, you know, America is already Egypt, man. We ain't got no reason to leave nowhere, because they already know that the Messiah is about to be revealed, the Exodus is coming, and they're trying to push the Antichrist spirits so that people get possessed by that. Oh, yeah, man, you know, this is where it is. We don't got to go nowhere. You know, we already been here anyway. Yeah. And they get left behind. And deceive, you know, they're going to have their time of grace and joy. And then they, in the end, it's not going to be worth anything, because the kingdom going to be being built. And that's what they did. They don't want people knowing the Messiah's on earth. That's why they said, you know, That's why the father said that, you know, for lack of knowledge, people perish. They're destroyed for lack of knowledge. So they think, yeah, man, yep, I knew it. I knew it all this time. And they stay here, you know, getting, you know, thrown in FEMA camps, you know, and so much more, man. You know, the mark of the beast is really about to amplify, and it's going to get serious out here. And if you're not in the faith, and if you're not, you know, exempt from this, which I'm going to be talking about soon, about the exemptions, you know, pertaining to the whole aspect, you know, of the of being under the tribe of Judah, you know, that's it, you know. Sorry to tell you that, you know, you got to just prove yourself, and you're going, you know, I don't want no one going through that, man. You know, they're not going to have no mercy on young, old, none of that, you know. And they already got their bunkers ready because they already know that time of the wrath is coming, that anger is coming, you know. People are going to be outraged when they start learning what's really going on. But listen to this devil right here. This stuff, they all agents, you know. And I want to just connect all of this because it's all just connected. But hear what they are, this is what he got to say, you know. This is just devil talk. There's no way around none of this, man. It's all about who got the eyes to see and ears to hear, you know. Let's listen to this.
So my father was in the military.
So they all got that military connection, you know.
Mm-hmm. That's how I was born in South Carolina.
See that Carol again. So the military and Carol, you know what I'm saying?
So I went back to live with my grandmother, right? Then we went back to move with my father when my father and my mother got back together. And at the time, my father was in Japan, Okinawa. Mm-hmm. Other than Japan for all of Hawaii, Honolulu.
Hear that Hawaii, they go to Obama connection, Honolulu, Lewis. That's why Obama rises out of Honolulu. So hint Lewis Eternal, you know, Obama is the Antichrist. You know, Hawaii is formed from fire, you know. Make you think you're thriving in beautiful paradise. And that's what they're preparing people for. You know what I'm saying? So you got the Carol, Hawaii, and, you know, the whole thing. Yeah, you know, my grandma, you know, all that talk, you know. Look at on the song, Sticking Stones, one app, one password, find your happy place. So they want to keep people here, you know, keep people trapped. One app, one password, everybody stay dwelling together. No exodus. You see they got the yellow light over here, too, because that means that time is ticking to prepare to make that turn, you know, before it go red, before you can't go, you see? No exodus, you know what I'm saying? That's why you see on the song Freedom, you see how they got Windy for the wind, the storm, that was talking about the great revealing, the whirlwind, and then they got CL for Carol Lewis, because they want to keep the house of the Lord abandoned. They're like, we want freedom, we want our freedom, you know? You know, you got the traffic scene on Doja Cat streets. You got LC, Lewis Carroll, initials again. You know, see how they already show how the Messiah, you know, Willie James. You see how they show he was the most wanted wolf for the Lamb of God. And James, because James just means Jacob. The 12 tribes of Jacob, Israel. So they got his height and his weight, 6'2-ish, 6'1", 6'2". Same height, you know, Obama the same height. You know, Obama like 6'1", 6'2", same height, you know. See how Godzilla and King Kong was fighting during the first election when Trump lost to Biden. You see Kong crapped that dome. He cracked the matrix because in Exodus 34:19, as it's written, those who come out the matrix are mine. So you see Kong cracks the dome because, you know, that's all just symbolic of the Messiah. You know, it's Kong, the king, preparing to sit on his throne, you know. Notice that was 2021 that came out. And then you got the new Kong movie about to drop, you know. Look at this right here. No way around none of this, you know. So he goes from breaking the dome after fighting Godzilla the first time to now King Kong is by the altars, by the pyramids. So they know the Exodus is about to fulfill, man. You know, so Kong is by the pyramids now. There's no way around none of this. It's all coming together. And you see he's battling. You see the whole thing right here. stuff is serious. You see that red Kong, that red one, it's just showing like all the anger that's about to come out of the saints. You know, Lucifer's kingdom about to fall. You know what I'm saying? So all of this stuff is all coming together. You know, it's all about who got the eyes to see and ears to hear. And that's why it's important knowing about the solar eclipse, you know, and what it really stands for. But I want to end that right here. Thank you for watching Hide and Seek TV. Much more is coming, man. Peace.